we're digging a new mouth for the Don River, right here, at what is currently Polson Slip. You can see where we've started excavating along the dock wall. This area will eventually become Canoe Cove, a place for people to connect with the water. The white structure on the left is the Atlas Crane, a heritage structure that will be incorporated into the new park at the river's edge. For now, we're storing soil and material here, but in 2024, this is where Promontory Park will be. This is the site of the former Marine Terminal 35 building. You can see where we're reinforcing the dock wall and preparing to build a promenade along the water's edge. Here, we've filled in Cousins Key and restored a natural shoreline. Along the new shoreline, we've built two new coves to make habitat for fish and other wildlife. Recent surveys by the Toronto and Region Conservation Authority found that the number of three native fish species has exploded since we created this new habitat. Now we're traveling east over the Keating Channel, currently the Don River's only outlet into Lake Ontario. The new alignment of Cherry Street is currently under construction. We're piling soil on top of the future road to compress it, a process called surcharging, and building new utilities that connect under the Keating Channel. We're also building future stormwater management infrastructure here. This is the sediment and debris management area, an important part of our design for flood protection. In winter 2022, we'll start excavation here to widen the Don River. We'll rebuild the Lakeshore Bridge and widen it, part of the design to add more space for people on bikes and foot along Lakeshore Boulevard East. The first step in this work was removing the ramps from the Gardiner Expressway to Lakeshore, part of the city's plans for rehabilitating the Eastern Gardiner. Now we're tracing the path of the future river valley. To date, we've excavated more than 911,000 cubic meters of soil from the river valley. That's more than 364 Olympic-sized swimming pools. We installed barriers to prevent contaminants from seeping into the new river. The Commissioner Street Bridge arrived in two halves over the summer. We held off on excavating the area under the bridge to make it easier to install. Here you can see it being unloaded from the barge it arrived on and driven into place on machines called self-propelled modular transporters. Now you can see the outline of the future river valley. We're creating the bottom and sides of the new river pathway by placing rocks, stones, and trees. Using sustainably harvested trees with their roots still attached allows us to create a riverbank that is naturally resistant to erosion during a major storm when flood waters would rush down the river. The rest of the time, it provides habitat for fish. The old fire hall in the Portlands is a designated heritage building. It was sitting in the way of a rebuilt Commissioner Street, so we moved it farther south. Once the new parks are built, the fire hall will sit in the entryway plaza and house public washrooms. We're back where we started, at Polson Slip. You can see the foundations for the Cherry Street South Bridge, which arrived at the beginning of December. Here are some photos showing how much has changed in the river valley since 2020. More exciting progress will happen in 2022. We'll start excavating the sediment and debris management area, planting greenery, and even flooding some sections of the new river valley. You'll be able to cross the new bridges along Cherry Street and Commissioner Street and look out over the future river valley directly. the Portlands. It's a game changer.